In the previous lesson, we set up this Nuxt application to interface with our Sanity project. What we want to do in this lesson is connect our Nuxt application to our Sanity backend and display data from Sanity here on the frontend. To do that, we need to install the Nuxt Sanity module that will facilitate the integration between our Nuxt and Sanity applications. To install it, let's go back to VS Code and run the following commands. Pull up the terminal and create a new one. First, let's go into the Sanity mission frontend directory. And then the modules we want to install is add Nuxt.js Sanity and Sanity client. Great. Now that the Nuxt Sanity module is installed, the next thing we want to do is configure the module. And the easiest way to do that is to come back to our Sanity mission project, copy the sanity.json file, which we have here, and copy it over to the front-end Nuxt project and paste it here. So this is basically telling our Nuxt application that we are connecting to the Sanity backend and the project ID is this and the data set we are querying from is this. Cool. The last thing we want to do, let's close this, is add the Nuxt Sanity module as a build module in our front-end application. And that is done inside our project's config file. In build modules, we go ahead and add Nuxt.js Sanity and save that. And with that done, we're basically done with connecting our Sanity mission backend application with our Nuxt frontend application. Now, to ensure that the integration is successful, let's go ahead and write some queries in our frontend application to fetch products from our Sanity application. Remember that Sanity uses GROQ, which is a query language that you can use to query Sanity datasets. To do that, let's revisit our studio so that I can show you what a GROQ query looks like. Back in Sanity Studio, this is a GROQ query that you can run to fetch all the products you have in this dataset. So basically, you can either run this command here to fetch the product, or we can copy it and run the command directly from our Nuxt application, which is what we're going to do. So let's clean up here. In the meantime, we can just see products. Great, let's go back to our project, and there we go, we have products. The next thing we want to do is import GROQ, and that should come from our module. All right, let's use Nuxt.js's async data to fetch the products. And we pass in the Sanity helper. And here, let's define a query. And this is exactly the same query that we have in our studio. So let's copy it from here and paste it in here. Great. Products. Let's fetch. And we want to fetch the query we defined. We have to await this because it returns a promise. And lastly, we want to return the products. Great. So let's clean this up and add a V4. And let's give it a key, which will be product ID. And in here, we can display the product title for all the products. So if we save this, we should now get all our products coming from Sanity showing up in the template. So let's look at the browser and find out. And there you go. We are successfully getting data from our Sanity application into our Nuxt project. Let's go ahead and clean this up a little bit more and take out all the style. Save that. And there you go. This is much better now. So this is how to connect your Sanity application to your Nuxt frontend application. In the next lesson, we'll look at how we can clean up the UI a little bit more and also implement dynamic page routing for all our product pages. See you there.